Norma Tomic Bulat was born in Ardaz Banat, Serbia, to Dina and Gladys Tomic. She immigrated to Canada with her parents and sister Jelena when she was 9 years old. She is currently involved in various businesses, including the operation of a family-owned supermarket.
My father was a barber, and he did four other jobs besides. He and mother both, mailman and milkman, and dad did, people needed it because he was a barber, if people needed to get their teeth out, in Old Country. He was a dentist, and if you had high blood pressure, used to put eel. But he was working, and my mom, and they were working real, real hard. So one of his friends said to him, he said, Dan, well, his name was Dina in Serbian, Dino, why don't you go to Canada or United States? Because you will kill yourself. They were young. He was only 27 when he came here. So Dad thought it over. He talked it over with Mother. I remember them talking in the night, because we all slept in one room. And he said, so next day he went to the town and got a permit if he could go across. He got his visa to come to Canada. So within a short time, he left, and so we stayed at the house, and my mother continued doing, being a mailman and a milkman. And then in the spring, when our rent was due, my mom decided that she was going to stay with my grandparents, instead of, because they said it'd be better for her instead of taking another year. They thought it was better that she should stay with them until he got a visa to bring Mother and I over. And July, it was that we left in July, but it was August the 12th. That we actually came on my birthday, we came to Canada. And in my story, it tells you all about from the beginning, from my father's birth to his death.
And where did you come in Canada? Windsor or?
Windsor, Ontario. Mm-hmm. I remember first of all, we came by boat. See, and then we went to France. And then we got the boat in France, and then from France we came to Halifax, and from Halifax by train to Windsor.
What did your father do, and what did
when we came here? My dad at the time was working at Ford's, but my mother, she was determined that he shouldn't be working at Ford's because it was hard for him, because he couldn't speak English very good, and on top of that, a piece of machinery fell and it hurt his nose. So Mother made him quit, and he got so he thought we were staying at, when we first came, we stayed at our godparents, rather my sister's godparents. Jiva and Darinka Kusha, we stayed at their place. And then within a few days, my father was determined that we're going to have a place of our own. So he rented a house and bought secondhand furniture. Now, he had this job at Ford's, but when he hurt his nose, my mother says no. So by that time, we had moved into our house and we had two boarders. And my dad went to our friend that he had stayed before and ask him for $50 to open his own beauty barber shop. And he says he couldn't, but a neighbor, one of the boarders, knew my dad, and he says, here's $50, you go and open. And then he got a barber, an inspector to come, and he gave him a shaven haircut, and he got his a business license for $2. That's how he started in business. And his first business was behind the Michigan Central off Crawford Avenue. And then we moved on Crawford Avenue, where my sister was born in 1930. And then while we were there, Dad and Mom had four boarders, and Mom was a saver. She saved every penny. And one year during the Depression, see, my sister was born May the 20th, 1919. She delivered the baby herself. And this chap asked, they used to have card playing, and so this guy said that he had a house that he wanted to sell, and he sold it to, so they went to see it, and he wanted $1,200. Mama says, I'll give you $7. So he wasn't going to take it. He's going to burn it down. But then the next day he come running over at 7 o'clock in the morning. Have you got the cash? Have you got the cash? So they went to the bank, and the bank opened, and they give him the cash, and the bank manager made the papers and everything, and the guy was able to, and the Mr. McCluckey was able to get to, he went to Scotland. And that's what, so we moved, my sister was only 18 days when we moved to 71 Jeanette Avenue. And I stayed there until I got married.
Did you go to school? You were only 9 years old when you came.
Yes. I went to John Campbell first, but I was only there a short time. And then I went to Prince Edward. And then from Prince Edward, I went to Victoria. And up to grade four. And from Victoria Avenue School, I went to Harry Guppy. 1934, I graduated from Harry Guppy School, and then I went to Kennedy Collegiate till I was in grade 11, and I quit school in February of 1937, and I got married in May of 1937.
Okay, tell us about your husband. How did you meet him, and also what happened after that?
Well, I met my husband, I was 15 years old when we had, on Walker Road, we had a Serbian picnic. And I was chosen as popularity queen at those times. Even now, we have it in Niagara Falls, but at that time, you have to go around and collect money and stuff like that for the church. So anyway, my husband had just come in 34. This is in 1935. So in August of 1935. But in 34 he had come from Yugoslavia. And he was living with his brother in a boarding house on Cadillac Street, and Mr. and Mrs. Woodyship, I can't remember their name, Uzelitz, Mr. and Mrs. Uzelitz. His brother lived there, and so did his, Pete Bulat and Bronco Bulat. And so he lived there too as a boarder. And he was helping his brother in the store, and he had the store on Charles Street. That was the first store. They used to call it Charles Grocery. And he was shy, and so it took him about a year to find out where I lived through my courtesy. I used to call them courtesy aunt because, and uncle, because he lived with us even after we moved to, the other three boarders went their way, but he moved with us when we moved to 71 Jeanette Avenue. So through them, they were good friends of Mr. and Mrs. Wazalitz, and so he found through them where I lived, and he came over. And my mother, by that time, my mother had a little grocery store in front of our, in the living room. And so he came to buy cigarettes. And they all, his brother already had three stores, you know. And he said, no, he didn't have the third store yet. He just said number one, that's the one on Charles Street. And then his Bronco had the one on Hickory Street. That was number two store. And so so he come down, and I that evening that he came first time, I was at a girlfriend's house, Christina Adams. And so he come over to buy a package of cigarettes. And my mother says, why are you buying cigarettes when your brother's got, you know, at that time he already had the third store because he was working in it. And he said, this was 1936. And so he stammered and staggered, and he said, well, he says, I met your daughter at Serbian picnic last year, and I would like her to teach me English. So my mother says, oh, that's nice. So next day, he comes bearing gifts. He come with flowers for my mother, or was it for me? I don't know which one. One of us got the flowers, and the other one the box of chocolates. And he brought, and then he started coming over more often and bringing books for me to teach him. And somehow we fell in love. And so it was, I was going to high school. I was going to Kennedy Collegiate at the time. So in December of 36, he gave me a ring. And my mother says, do you know what you're doing? You know, she says to me, because I was only 17. I says, oh, I didn't think it was anything serious, you know. But she says, you gotta remember that you're accepting an engagement ring. So I took it, you know, and well, like I said, we were in love. And on following Saturday, we went on our honeymoon, and I got the measles. So I went with on my honeymoon with measles. The rest all looked at Niagara Falls. I stayed in my motel room. So after that, when we got back, we had this number three store, so I started working with him. 28 Albert Road, when I got pregnant with my son. And my Peter was, during the time that I was pregnant, my husband was working for, with a friend. He got mad at his brother again, as usual. He gets mad at him, and he was working for with a friend on Charles Street, and they used to call it International Market. I see his pictures in the paper. I'll show it to you later on, you know. And so when my son was born. He was born the day after Christmas. My mother was trying to tell me how to deliver a baby. She delivered my sister, you know, herself. And so just at the time, it was Christmas Day of 1940, and my son was born the next day, 26th of 8 o'clock in the morning. So after that, I went to move to stay with my mother and dad. Well, the baby was small, And they negotiated to buy an apartment building. We had the christening there first at this house, and we named him after my brother-in-law, Peter. And then we had been there, a year or so. And I was nursing the baby and taking the streetcar back and forth every 4 hours. So finally at 6 months, my mother says, that's enough. She said, so she started giving him, I had the formula ready. And so she gave him formula. And then we decided to move, then my parents bought, sold this one and bought an apartment building. They paid $6,000 for on 853, 855, 57, 59 Langlois. And it was a beautiful building. It was a brick. It was built by Blake Brothers. And so we, my parents took, there was four apartments. They took the apartment downstairs and we got the apartment upstairs.
So when did you start your own business?
In 1942, when I was expecting my my daughter, Pete helped us build the store on College, 1655 College. And so the store opened on my when my daughter was born. The day my daughter was born, while I was in the hospital, they opened the store and call on the call of Bullets Market, number 3. And so anyway, time went by, and my parents moved to, like I told you, they moved to Bell River. And then in 1944, I was expecting my third child, that was Sylvia, and she was 1954. I said to my mother, I wanted to take a beauty course, because I said I had four children, you see. So I thought, well, if I took a beauty course, my mother could prepare the dinner and that. So I went to school. I went from October till May, and then I graduated. And in May, my parents decided to go to Europe, and they went to, my sister and her husband were looking after the hotel. And so I opened a beauty shop in my basement when I got my license, you know. But it seems that you have to have a license. I didn't know that. I just, you know, you think you could. So anyway, when my parents went to Europe, they went by car, and they went by boat. And they went to visit their hometown where my father was born, and that they were the first car to go there. Imagine what a thrill it was for them. So anyway, they went in May, and in September we went to pick them up in New York, my sister and I. And by that time I was pregnant with number 5. Well, I did forget to remember 1948 when the Budimirs worked for us. Mm-hmm. I forgot that. Mm-hmm. But
that's yeah, what, I yeah. have it in record.
Yeah, you have it. Yeah, mm-hmm. I just remember that now. So anyway, so when my parents came back, Helen and I went to, my sister Helen and I went to New York, and she drove back with them, and I had by that time a beauty shop on College, I mean, in Campbell and Tecumseh Road. I had one room, so when they came back, I had that beauty shop, and I went to, the baby was born in April of April 22nd, 1956. So I thought, oh, before the baby was born, I had bought a place right next door to the store, a house that I got for $60 down and $60 a month at $5,500, which I wanted to have as a beauty shop because it was so close. But there was one American lady in the, that wouldn't let me because she thought I was going to have open a, what do you call, like a confectionery. Why should I? My husband had the store. I don't need a confectionery. I wanted a beauty shop. So then I rented the place to my to a couple that had 8 children. So, like I said, time flew by, and I couldn't get that. So I, like I said, I couldn't get that place. So I went and rented the place on Tecumseh, and then when the baby was born, I went to the Grace Hospital and
left the store and went to real estate. So
it was in 1967 that I went into real estate in 60. Well, I graduated in 67, but I went I took the course in 66, in the fall of 66, and then I was working for George Banyan at the time, and I went into real estate because, and then I rented my beauty shop out.
So and, what did Dan do? Did
he was still running the store, okay. You know, and we were living in back of the beauty shop, I mean of the store, grocery store. And my daughter was helping him in the store now, you see. And her husband, he was working someplace too. I don't remember where he was working. I know he was driving a truck. But then she had the little boy. He was born in 64.
After 55 years of marriage, Norma and her husband Dan Bulat are separated. They have 5 children, 1 son Peter, and 4 daughters, Sika, Dolly, Sylvia, and Diane. They also have 15 grandchildren and 4 great-grandchildren. Norma still keeps herself active with several businesses and other activities.